Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and today I'll be showing you how to create this beautiful animation effect in PowerPoint 2016. I will be explaining this tutorial step by step so that you can easily understand this animation process. So without wasting any time, let's get started with the tutorial. First of all, you need to insert 3 images in your slide. All the images must be of same size and should be completely overlapping with each other. You can take the help of the crop tool to resize the images. Then select all the images using the shortcut keys Ctrl plus A. Go to the format tab and apply this circle frame to the images. Keep all the images selected. Zoom out a little bit and then increase the size of the images such that only the corners of the slide should be visible. In simple words, make the images larger than the slide as shown. After arranging all 3 images in the slide, it's time to begin with the animation process. Select the first image and add fade entrance effect to it. Set the duration of animation to 2 seconds. Then add grow or shrink animation effect to the image. Open the effect options and set the size to 20%. Under the timings tab, select start with previews and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds and click OK. Then we need to add a motion path to this image. Add a left motion path to the image and drag the path to make it diagonal as shown. Again, select start with previews and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds. Let's see what we have achieved so far. You can adjust the motion path of the image in case the image is not moving towards the desired direction. Alright, now for the rest of the images, you need to apply same animations with almost same properties as we had applied to the first image, except that you need to change the direction of the motion path for each of the image. Let me just show this to you. Select the second image and add fade entrance effect to it. Under the timings tab, select start with previews, add a delay of 1 second and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds. Now add grow or shrink animation effect and set the size to 20%. Under the timings tab, select start with previews and add a delay of 1 second and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds. Now add a motion path in the upward direction. Select start with previews, add a delay of 1 second and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds and click OK. And now here comes the most crucial part of this animation effect. You need to adjust the length of the motion path so that all the 3 images are in line with each other. You can see that the second image is a little below than the first image, and in order to rectify this, we need to increase the length of the motion path. Now all this is based upon hit and try method, that is, you need to try again and again adjusting the motion path until all the images are completely in line with each other. When you are satisfied with the position of the second image, you can now begin with the animation of the third image. Apply same animation effects with same properties and just increase the delay time of each effect to 2 seconds. Regarding the motion path effect, apply diagonal upright motion path to the image and set the properties as shown. Now again, you need to adjust the length of the motion path. You need to play the slideshow again and again to check whether the image is moving towards the desired position or not. Let's see what we have achieved so far. Perfect. So this is a very beautiful way to present your images in the slide. To further beautify this animation effect, you can add text headings to the images. Insert the text boxes and write the desired text. Again, you need to play the slideshow to check the position of the text boxes. Select the first text box and add float down entrance effect to it. Open the effect options and select start with previous. Add a delay of 2 seconds and set the duration of animation to 1 second. Apply same animation effect with same properties to the other two text boxes, except that increase the delay of the second text box to 3 seconds and that of the third text box to 4 seconds. Let's have a look on our final effect. Amazing. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.